Hello, I'm George Cruz, your host, and thanks for joining us again on the Senior Report. On the Senior Report, we try to keep you in the community updated on healthcare services and products that'll benefit you in the community. Today, we'll be interviewing Dr. Kevin Lukenda, Medical Director of Delia Nursing Rehabilitation Center in Linden, who's been in practice for almost 27 years. He has a practice in Linden called the Linden Family Medical, located at 850 Northwood Avenue in Linden. We'll also tour the new Healthy Heart Pathway Cardiac Subacute Rehab Unit and Delia Gardens Assisted Living Community at Delia. I like to call it Linden's best kept secret because not many people know we have a 40-bed community in Linden. Welcome to the Senior Report, Dr. Lukenda. Can you tell us a little bit about your practice, yourself? I know your family's from the community.
Certainly, George. First of all, I'd like to thank you for inviting me here. I'm very excited about Delair's new cardiac wing, which we're going to talk about today. My name is Dr. Kevin Lukenda. I was born and raised here in Linden, literally three blocks from where I'm sitting now. I was raised with a family of nine. My mother and father raised seven kids, all in the service industry, doctors, dentists, psychologists, religious, firefighters. So we all have a sense in the family of giving back to the community of Linden and the surrounding towns of which we grew up in. I have a family practice down on Wood Avenue, where I've been there for over 24 years. It's a general family practice. Most of my patients are older than 60 in the geriatric population, which made me become affiliated with Delair the first year I started my practice. I joined Delair 25 years ago when I started my practice, because most of my patients ended up here in rehab or in the nursing home. My practice consists of myself, Lisa Genova, who's a nurse practitioner, and Dr. Nishami Patel. We offer general health care from anyone 18 and older. We have plenty of patients well over 100 years old in the practice. And a big part of my practice, a daily part of my practice, is coming here to Delair and treating my patients, both on the subacute side, people who are going to be able to go back home, and the long-term side, people who reside here permanently.
So what is your involvement in Delair Nursing and Rehab and the Healthy Heart Pathway Cardiac Rehab Unit?
There's basically two commitments I have to Delair. One is that of my own private patients. When my patients leave the hospital or my patients need nursing home care, I admit my own personal private patients, including multiple family members over the last 20 years that have been here at Delair. So I use this as a hospital subacute setting for my own patients. Number two, I'm the medical director here at Delair Nursing Home and Subacute, and we're starting our Healthy Heart Initiative, which is a cardiac monitoring for patients who have cardiac issues after they leave the hospital.
Great. So what exactly is cardiac subacute rehabilitation?
After someone suffers a cardiac event, a heart attack, a stroke, an irregular heartbeat, a stent, they're usually in the hospital for a couple days, and then most of them are forced to leave to go home. Now, most of these patients are not healthy enough to go home, so Delair was very innovative in starting the subacute cardiac care. So before going home, but after being discharged from the hospital, we have an opportunity to keep an extra eye on our patients with cardiac monitoring to assess them after they just had a cardiac procedure. So if someone had a heart attack after they're discharged from the hospital, they could come here to rehab themselves, but they would be monitored with a cardiac monitor. Someone who has a stent, someone who has a change in their cardiac medications, someone who had any kind of cardiovascular procedure, pacemaker insertion, it allows us to keep a closer eye on them after the procedure is done, instead of going home and us seeing them in a week or two after being discharged from the hospital. We get to see them here on a daily basis after the hospital discharge.
Right. So if a patient's at the hospital, they've had a cardiac procedure, how do you access this service, cardiac rehab?
Well, that's where the hospital social services and case management comes in. This is a very innovative situation. This is the first subacute rehab that offers cardiac rehab on a subacute level. So when the patient's in the hospital and they're getting the cardiac procedure, we're going to have the foresight to get case management and the discharge planners to make sure the patients can be discharged here for further care.
Okay, so why rehab at a unit, a subacute unit, as opposed to an outpatient rehab unit?
Well, outpatient cardiac units are popular now, but it just doesn't give us the continuity of care that an inpatient unit like Del Air has. We have nurses here 24/7. We have a cardiac monitor where the patient's connected to a heart monitor while they're here for 24 hours a day. And God forbid there's any negative event that happens, the patient will be here in Del Air on a cardiac ward and not home, where 911 would have to be called and sent to the patient's house. Where if an event happens and the patient's here, there's nurses, there's medicines, there's cardiac monitors, and there's the necessary cardiac equipment, including 24/7 on-call cardiologists that are here to assist the patient who has difficulty with their medical situation.
Would the outcomes be any better in subacute as opposed to outpatient rehab?
The studies show that after any kind of cardiac procedure, whether it's bypass surgery, pacemaker insertion, stenting, there is a certain amount of mortality, death rate that follows those procedures. Being in an inpatient setting will allow us to act quicker to deal with the medical crisis sooner and thereby improve our outcomes in a positive way.
Thank you. We're also going to be joined by Marjorie Rizzola. She's a corporate registered nurse for Del Air Nursing and Rehabilitation Center. And we'll be introducing her and she'll be showing us part of the unit, and Dr. Lucena will join us. We're actually at Del Air right now in one of the offices, and we'll be touring the 3C subacute cardiac rehab unit. Marjorie Rizzola, registered nurse, board certified in gerontology of Hospicom, parent company of Del Air Nursing and Rehabilitation Center. Welcome to the Senior Report, Marjorie.
Thank you.
This question is for both you and Dr. Lucena. What type of diagnosis would you see and treat at Del Air's Healthy Heart Pathway Cardiac Care Unit? And where would these patients be referred from?
Well, most of the patients obviously have coronary artery syndrome, which is blocked arteries to the heart. We would also treat arrhythmias, which are irregular heartbeats, either beats that go too fast, beats that go too slow, beats that are irregular. We would see pacemaker patients, people who just had a pacemaker inserted, people who've had cardiac artery bypass surgery, patients who've had stenting, patients who are having their medicines changed from one medicine to another, and it's very important to monitor their heart rate and rhythm while we change some of these cardiac meds. Those will be most of the type of diagnoses that we'll see right here at the Healthy Heart Program.
Can a physician refer, let's say the physician isn't credentialed here, can they still send their patients here?
And without a doubt, we're hoping to recruit more physicians and make this more aware to the physicians out there, because this is a need that the physicians in the area have, monitoring their patients after a cardiac procedure. So one of the plans is, now that we have this Healthy Heart Program here, we're expecting other physicians to join Del Air now that we have this innovative technology.
This question is for you, Marjorie.
Okay.
Who would monitor the monitors?
Well, we have, as you can see behind us, is the central monitoring, telemetry monitoring center. The patients will be wearing a telepack, and the nurses who are monitoring are registered nurses with LPN. So the ratio will be a 1-to-4, 1-to-5 ratio for the patients here. All the nurses have been trained on telemetry and ACLS certified.
Well, you have nurses that have certifications like ACLS, Advanced Cardiac Life Support.
Yes, we also have our teletechs who are certified, and they will be 24/7 monitoring the telemetry unit, the patients.
Okay, and you do have a manager for the unit?
Yes,
we do. Nurse manager?
Yes, we do.
And who would that be?
That would be Cheryl Madamba.
Okay, next we'll meet with Cheryl Madamba, who will give us a tour of the unit and the equipment that will be used. I'd like to introduce Cheryl Madamba, registered nurse and nurse manager of the Healthy Heart Pathways Cardiac Rehabilitation Unit at Delhi Nursing and Rehabilitation. Welcome to the show, Cheryl. Cheryl, can you tell me a little bit about the equipment and monitors that you'll be using for the cardiac rehab unit?
Okay, so we use Mindray telemetry monitors, and this is the telepack. This will be connected to the patient, to their chest. We use the five leads. We'll be able to monitor their heart rate and their heart, if there's any irregular beats, we'll be able to see it here on the telepacks. And also there'll be somebody here that's gonna be monitoring it as well if there's no nurse inside the room. The patients are able to use this button right here also to call the nurses if there's anything that they feel or anything that they need. And also included is the call bell that we have. But this one will ring right here, and then we will be able to respond to them as fast as we can.
So this is all wireless.
Yes.
And there's always someone monitoring the heart rhythms and
yes, there will patterns. Be a teletech here, and we will have the RNs here, and they will also have the LPNs that are going to be taking care of the patients.
What if there's an emergency at 3 o'clock in the morning, cardiac emergency?
Any emergencies at 3 o'clock in the morning, we utilize telemedicine. But on a daily basis, we have a cardiologist in-house, and the nurse practitioner for that cardiology group will be here every single day. And we also have the nurse practitioners from our medical director and the other doctors that come here. So there will always be a physician in-house.
Cheryl's gonna give us a tour of the rooms, the telemedicine prompt, and we'll do that now. Shortly afterwards, we'll be visiting with Stanley Shimura, the wellness director for the Delia Gardens Assisted Living Community.
The rooms are private and semi-private. This is the typical semi-private room. We also have 32-inch flat-screen TVs and also 24-hour monitoring.
Cheryl, after a stay at Delia's Healthy Heart Pathway Cardiac Rehab Subacute Unit, would you refer a patient to outpatient rehab?
Well, Delaware has its own inpatient and outpatient rehab.
So your social worker, case managers can refer
yes.
to the outpatient rehab program.
Yes.
Great.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for joining us on
no
a senior problem. Report, Cheryl. I want to thank Dr. Lukenda, Delaware's medical director, Marjorie Rizzola, corporate RN, and Cheryl Madamba, RN unit manager, for joining us and keeping us informed on the latest in cardiac subacute rehab. At the Healthy Heart Pathway Cardiac Rehab Unit at Delia Nursing and Convalescent Center. Delia has an assisted living community called Delia Gardens. It's kind of Linden's best kept secret. It's a 40-bed assisted living community, and it's the most affordable assisted living community that I know of. We'll speak to Stanley Shimura, RN and Wellness Director at Delia Gardens next. Hello, Stanley. Thanks for joining us on the Senior Report. Today we have Stanley Shimura, Wellness Director for Delia Gardens, the assisted living at Delia Nursing and Rehabilitation Center. I like to call it Linden's best kept secret. Not many people in the community know that we have a 40-bed assisted living community in Linden. Stanley, as you know, on the Senior Report, we try to keep the community up to date with healthcare products and services for the community. Delia Gardens is a smaller, more intimate assisted living community. I know that there are some really big communities out there. You have a 40-bed assisted living community with semi-private rooms, restaurant-style dining. Can you tell us a little bit about Delia Gardens?
Sure, be happy to. Delia Gardens, as George said, is a 40-bed assisted living unit. We have the services of our attending physicians for our residents. Our physicians come to see our residents on a regular basis. I make rounds with the physicians to make sure that our residents are receiving the best care that we can possibly deliver. As I said, they come on a regular basis, but we also provide the services, George, of different healthcare services. For example, we have a visiting dentist who comes in and sees our residents on a regular basis. Everybody gets their six-month checkup. We also have a podiatrist who comes in and sees our residents on a regular basis every 3 months. We have an audiologist come in and make sure our residents are hearing well. And we also have the services of an optometrist who comes in and changes lenses for our residents to make sure their vision is sharp.
What if a patient needs rehab services? Are there, can they access inpatient and outpatient rehab services?
Yes, they can. That's a good question, George. If we see a decline in one of our patients, I get together with the physician and the physical therapist or occupational therapist so that we can plan a program together so that we can get them up to their maximum level of function. And after they've reached that, they're discharged from those services, and we as nurses make sure that they reach the maximum level and we try to prevent a decline.
Okay. Now, I'm sure that there's cost involved. What are the costs if you move into an assisted living community like Delaware Gardens?
Okay, the cost of our facility is $100 a day, and that would be also be a requirement to have a $3,100 deposit.
Okay, and if they can't afford that, will Medicaid pay for this?
Absolutely.
Very good. Can you tell me what the admission criteria is for Delaware Gardens?
Okay. We're looking.
Who would qualify for this in the community? Because we have seniors in the community that are really struggling to care for themselves at home. Is this the type of person that you're looking for?
Yes, we can provide services for that type of a resident. We're looking for somebody who's alert and oriented, who needs some assistance with their medications. We'll make sure that they get the proper medication at the proper time. We'll also look if we have to adjust any medications as well.
Stanley, can you give us a tour of the unit?
Of course. Follow me.
Thank you.
This is one of our typical semi-private rooms. It's spacious, room for two beds. We have comfortable air conditioning in the summertime, warm heat in the wintertime. Bath is shared by two people.
Do you offer private rooms at all anymore, or are they all semi-private?
Most of them are semi-private. Some veteran residents do have private rooms.
Okay. So those are the ones who have been here the longest.
That's correct.
Okay. And the dining area?
I'll show you the dining area as well.
So this is the dining area?
Yes, this is our recently redecorated and well-appointed dining room where our residents are served restaurant-style meals three times a day from our steam table. We wait on them. They're provided with a menu 1 week in advance, and they make their selections from that menu. If they don't like an item on a menu, there is an alternate that's always offered for all three meals.
Very good. All right, so dining and entertainment as well? Do you have an activities program?
We do have an activities program. We have an activities calendar that's posted in our corridor. There's activities 7 days a week. We have bingo. We have card games. Our book club is very active as well. During the summer, up in our well-appointed patio area, we have barbecues every Wednesday.
Very good. So if there's a senior in our community that's struggling to take care of themselves at home, they have private pay or Medicaid.
That's correct.
They may qualify. Do you have beds available?
We have several beds available at this time. I would welcome the community to come in and take a look at our facility, and I'd be happy to give them a tour.
Very good. So it's good to know that there are beds available in case there's people in the community that are struggling to care for themselves, or if there's a younger person who has a parent that's struggling to take care of themselves, there are beds available. I'm sure there's a limited amount of beds available. So by calling Stanley Shimura at 908-862-3399, access speak to Stanley Shimura, the wellness director nurse. He can review the case and determine if there's a need for assisted living. Thank you, Stanley.
You're welcome, George.
Thank you very much. I want to thank Dr. Lucinda Dallaire's medical director, Marjorie Rizzola, the corporate RN for Dallaire, Cheryl Madamba, the registered nurse and unit manager for the cardiac rehab unit, and Stanley Shimura, the wellness director for Dallaire Gardens, the assisted living community. Until next time, we'll see you on the Senior Report.